ready to match the star. James Darren. Brett Summers. Nipsey Russell. Juliet Mills. Richard Dawson. And Teddy White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star.
Somebody put you up to that. Did you do that, Johnny Olsen? Who did it? You done it.
That wasn't a standing ovation. They were fixing to leave.
Did you do that, Juliet Mills? You didn't do that. Are you having trouble with your seat?
I'll just get this pumped out. I left a standing ovation and they stole my seat.
Oh.
The animal lover here.
I thank you for that. Are you all ready to have a go at it?
Yeah.
We're ready to have a go at it.
All right. Let's get over there.
Okay, more than you think. What I mean is, this is our first show of the year of our Lord, right. 1975, and it's interesting to hear Johnny Olsen say Match Game 75. I found it interesting. Wasn't that fascinating?
Yes, it was. Yeah. Nice to start out the new year.
Yes,
and we certainly enjoyed you a lot at home on our TV in 1974.
Well, good. I thank you very much.
You've got lots of friends. Well,
okay. Well, where were we last time? You had your first round question, and you hadn't had yours. But we've got a question for you, and we'll find out what it is right after we find out what this is. You ready? I shall push the magic button and reveal the other first round question for you, Tom. Listen carefully. Everybody plays. Harold was thrown out of the amusement park for taking a blank in the tunnel of love.
Oh, Weird Harold.
What? I didn't say Weird Harold.
Oh, no?
Oh, that's, you know. All I said was Harold was thrown out of the amusement park for taking a blank in the tunnel of love.
Oh, I got it, honey.
So did
the ball that. Is in your court.
Well, we're not playing.
You're not playing? Are you thinking about that, Thomas?
Yeah. I think I have.
Harold was thrown out of the amusement park for taking a blank in the tunnel of love.
Not allowed? No?
Am I the only one?
Oh, I love this show. So I walk around and I can look.
Wild horses wouldn't get it.
All right, I won't look at you. All right, I'm just checking on everybody.
Oh, I'm fine now.
How is it, Jimmy Boy?
Terrific.
Now, okay, now we're ready for the old Tom winners here. Harold was thrown out of the amusement park for taking a blank in the tunnel of love.
A nude.
Taking a nude?
Woman. Yeah.
Really?
What? Yeah, really. That's what he did.
A nude?
I've been through the tunnel of love several times.
You've been through the... Now, wait a minute. He says he's been through the tunnel of love several times. And how'd you get her past the turnstile?
Well, I didn't take a nude.
Oh, I see.
That was Harold
who took the nude in there. He says Harold took a nude in the tunnel of love. What do you say to that?
I don't believe that.
Yeah,
no, those rides are so long.
Yes.
And if you go in alone,
it's dark, isn't it?
Yes, yeah, and it's very, very tough to find anything. And
yes.
I think he just wanted to relieve himself. He tinkled.
Oh. May we see your answer, if you please,
yes,
madam?
I said he took an elf because he was Irish.
He took an elf?
Yes.
All right, Nipsey.
Well, there was so much water in the tunnel of love that Harold didn't think they'd notice. He took a bath.
Took a bath in the tunnel of love. Harold was thrown out of the amusement park for taking a blank in the tunnel of love. What did you say?
Well, I finally found a wood. He took a tinkle.
Took a tinkle. All right. No nude so far,
nude
Thomas.
So far.
He's looking for a nude lady in the tunnel of love, Richard.
I'm worried about an audience that cheers Tinkle.
My Harold merely took a bath.
Merely took a bath. Right. Great. It's not allowed in the tunnel of love. What is allowed in the tunnel of love? He says take a nude in there. What do you say,
they
Betty?
They may cheer Tinkle, but they'll boo Speedboat.
Okay, so at this moment it's 1-0. We go to round 2 and ask Carol to make her selection.
I'd like B again.
B, last time you matched Jimmy, so Jimmy, you'll lay out this time. Now, here's this. Not very many people know this, but John J. Audubon, the noted bird lover, first gained fame when he gave a bald eagle a blank. John J. Audubon, the noted bird lover and painter, you know. He painted all the birds, did beautiful jobs. He first gained fame when he gave a bald eagle a blank.
Oh, I got it!
Oh, that's a... Well, that's an easy one, isn't it?
Honey, I got it. You don't have to worry about it. I got it. Just, you're home free.
All right. We're waiting for Nipsey.
I'll be right with you.
In the tradition of Charles Nelson Reilly, you're late again. Is that it? Okay. Well. All right. Now we'll come over here to Carol. Not very many people know this, Carol, but John J. Audubon, the noted bird lover and painter, first gained fame when he gave a bald eagle a blank.
Okay, a toupee.
A toupee. Ha-ha! All the wigged people applauded out there. What do you say, Jim? Oh, you don't play this time. You play this time. What do you say? Oh, speaking of toupees, here's Miss Wig Lady.
Da, 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 da. Gave him a rug.
Rug and toupee. Okay, there's one for you, Carol. What did he do for that bald eagle?
I never thought he would do that, but I knew he was a bird lover. I thought he gave him a scalp massage.
A scalp massage? Really? Oh, he is a weirdo. First gained fame when he gave a bald eagle a...
A haircut.
A haircut.
I see.
Well, bald eagles aren't really bald, are they?
Well, that's how they got bald. No. He gave them a haircut. What'd you say, Richard? She's your countrywoman, not mine.
Pardon, monsieur?
I am a stranger. I don't know that.
What do you say about this bald eagle?
In my home country of France, we always say toupee.
Toupee.
Accent probably.
Oui, oui, oui. Pardon. L'aiglon,
My Gallic friend on my right really does know his birds. Toupee.
Toupee.
That's four for you. How about that?
Okay, Tom. You're going to have to match four celebrities to stay in the game. However, five will win a game. We'll see if that happens right after we see about this. Now we are ready to conclude this game. Are you ready, Tom?
I'm ready.
Here we go. You need 4 to tie, 5 to win. The doctor said to Ewell Gibbons. He said, I am referring you to a tree surgeon. You're suffering from blank. He said, I'm referring you to a tree surgeon. You're suffering from blank. That'll be $80, please.
Ewell Gibbons said, who'd he say?
The doctor said to Ewell Gibbons, I'm referring you to a tree surgeon. You're suffering from
the dumb. Okay, you're a perfect person. I got no argument with you, James. Oh, I spelled it. I mean, I spelled it wrong. I spelled it so wrong that it would be misinterpreted.
Okay.
You'll love it. It's all right. Nice answer.
You're finished here. All right.
Can we protest a question?
No, you can't protest a question.
I think we should.
Can we beat up the writers?
Yes. All right, here we go with Tom. Now, Ted, a lot of stake here for Thomas Winters now. The doctor said to Ewell Gibbons, I'm referring you to a tree surgeon. You're suffering from...
Hickory nuts. I haven't thought of anything else.
I never looked at hickory nuts as an undesirable condition of any kind. I like hickory nuts. I wouldn't. You couldn't suffer. What about that? What do you say to that?
Well, I always thought he was kind of strange, you know.
Yeah.
And I said that he was suffering from the nuts. I mean, the crazies, you know.
Yeah, okay, hickory nuts. That's one match. That's right, he's always eating hickory nuts, right, Brett?
Well, I thought because I come from Maine and he comes from Indiana, I was sure he was going to go straight to the reality of it and say damp root.
Damp root. That's right. That gives it makes a tree's leaves turn yellow and
yes,
fall and the tree
all kinds
dies.
Of awful
oh, it's terrible things.
Thing.
Nipsey?
And to prove that I'm nothing like Brett, I thought he said
thank
dry
heavens.
Root.
Dry root. Got to match the others to stay in the game. Thomas, here we go. I'm referring you to a tree surgeon you're suffering from. He said hickory nuts.
Leaf mold.
Leaf mold. So that means Carol Copeland wins the game. What did you have there? Splinters. Splinters. Congratulations. Okay. Carol, you stand by for a moment. Got to say goodbye to Tom Winters here. It was a pleasure meeting you, Tom.
Well, it's a real pleasure to be here, Gene.
I'm glad you enjoyed it, and I'm glad you won some money, $1,200. Many thanks for being with us. The Match Game 75, Thomas Winters. You know, Carol, not many people can say what you and Tom Winters are able to say. You've been on Match Game 74 and Match Game 75, haven't you?
Yes, I have, and okay. I've loved every minute of it.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, Carol. We're going to have a go at the big money right now. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Patent blank. Oh. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250, and the third, $100. Which celebrities would you like to get an assist from?
Richard.
Patent shoes.
Patent leather shoes. Patent yeah. leather shoes.
Yeah.
All right.
Betty.
Patent pending.
Patent pending. All right. You got two there now.
And Nipsey Russell.
Nipsey, have you got one?
Patent medicine.
Okay. So there they are, Carol, all three of them. Patent medicine, patent leather shoes, and patent pending. You may choose one of those, or if you've got a better idea that you think would be a winner, give us that.
The first thing that popped in my mind was patent pending.
Patent yeah. pending.
Right.
Okay. All right, patent pending is the one we are looking for. Let's find out if it's up there. And if it's there, where is it? Is it under the $100 response? I ask you. No, patent medicine is there, though. That's the one that Nipsey gave you. Okay.
Right.
We're looking for patent pending. Here is the $250 response. Patent yeah! pending. Congratulations. You got it. All right. That's one Betty gave you, right? Okay. What do you think's under the big one?
Patent leather.
Patent leather? All right. May we see it, please? Patent leather. Okay. That was Richard's answer. Now you got $250. You're going to play for $2,500 to collect. You've got to match one of them head to head. This will have to be an exact match. Which one do you choose?
Oh, they're all good. Richard.
Okay, Richard, you get ready to write. Here is the $2,500 question. You swing around and face me if you would, please. Thank you. Blank dandy. Blank dandy. D-A-N-D-Y. All right, he's finished. Now, she's mumbling to herself, and she's going to give us an answer which he thinks will match Richard. What do you say to that, blank dandy?
Yankee Doodle Dandy.
Yankee Doodle Dandy. That's the song, right?
Right.
I'm my Yankee Doodle. All right. Richard, you know he's English. He's been here a long time, but he is English. Right
British.
To the core. British.
Right, Bob. Oh, right.
For $2,500, may we see your answer, please?
No.
For $2,550 and 27 cents.
Do I hear 28?
All right.
Listen, why didn't you go with leather with me, Carol?
I'm sorry.
You've got people here that love you. I love you dearly.
I'm sorry.
This could have been $5,000 instead of a measly $2,500.
$2,850, and we'll come back to you right after this. Good girl. Okay, now this lady has won a bundle of money. She's got $2,850. She's happy about that, and she's going to meet another player here. Here's Shirley Gaynor. Hi, Shirley.
Hi.
Now, we're ready to find out a little bit about you, if you please, ma'am.
I'm from Birmingham, Alabama. I'm
married. Yeah, that's Fanny Flag territory.
Yeah. And I'm married, and I have one child.
Okay. You ever watch his program?
I sure do.
You know how it goes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, shall we have a go at it?
Yeah.
All right. And now, you as a challenger make a selection, Shirley.
B.
You want B?
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. New game. Alice said to Ted, I still say that man was not Santa Claus. Sure, he brought us some gifts, but he took our blank. You have to stop laughing at some point and write something. In your beautiful red dress, you look like Mrs. Santa Claus there. Isn't that a great gay Christmas color? Christmas past and all that?
No, compré inglés.
You don't speak English?
But we don't celebrate that holiday.
Noel?
The first Noel, well, we did that.
Yeah.
But we don't repeat it.
My whole tears.
Oh, you're finished, yes. Right?
Wait a minute, I'm finished.
Your light is lighted, indicating you're finished, and you're not finished.
But I am finished.
Okay.
Oh, honey, I was finished years ago.
We don't care to hear any more about that. Shirley Gaynor, listen to me, not to them. Alice said to Ted, I still say that man was not Santa Claus. Sure, he brought us some gifts, but he took our blank.
Tree.
He took our tree?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. He took the tree. Well, I think they were rooting for you, and, well, we'll find out what happens. Jimmy?
I know that guy from Philadelphia. He used to pose as Santa Claus all the time, but he always took your TV.
Took the TV set. Okay, she says took the tree. What'd you say?
Well, I want to tell you one thing.
Why?
That I'm from Birmingham.
Yes.
And she don't talk the least bit funny like Fanny does, do she?
No, she don't talk that funny way at all.
Why, that little devil took our green stamps.
Took the green stamps. Rifled all the drawers. Left the silver and the flatware and everything. Took the green stamps, did he?
Took the green stamps.
Well, what a weird burglar that was. Nipsey, what did his burglar take?
Well, I was thinking about my uncle. He hung his sock up by the fireplace, but the health department made him take it down. Took our stockings.
Took the stockings. Didn't put anything in them, just took the stockings. Juliet, what did you say to this? He brought us some gifts, but he took our...
Turkey.
Stole the turkey. Boy, this is a weird collection of answers if I've ever heard one.
Aren't you glad you're yes. English, Dickie?
Yes. Now...
They're really getting at me today, aren't they?
They are
getting
at you. The
beginning of the new year and
yes.
all that.
What do you say, sir?
Well, I say if Shirley Gaynor had a stepson... He'd be known as a half-gainer.
Well, the little devil brought some presents, but he took our kid.
Took the kid. The answer she's looking for is tree.
Who was sitting in front of the TV at the
Who
time?
Who was sitting in front of the TV?
He couldn't get back
no
up the chimney
Christmas
with the
trees
tree.
Were stolen. Let's see what we've got for you in the little goodie bag here of the first round questions. Whoops, upside down there. Betty White said to Richard Dawson. Do you remember those beautiful mushrooms I was growing in my garden? Well, I just found out that they're poisonous. So, I decided to give one little mushroom to blank. That's what Betty White said to Richard Dawson. Those beautiful mushrooms growing in my garden. Well, I just found out they're poisonous, so I decided to give one little mushroom to blank.
Happy New Year.
All right. Everybody ready? Nipsey.
I'm ready.
Don't fool around, Nipsey. Just write something.
I'm not fooling around. I'm just writing. Nag,
nag, nag. Now, Carol Copeland. Betty White said to Richard Dawson, do you remember those beautiful little mushrooms I was growing in my garden? Well, I just found out they're poisonous, so I decided to give one little mushroom to blank.
I love her. I think she's beautiful, and I'm going to say Brett.
Okay. Well, she says she loves Brett, but she's going to say Brett anyway. What'd you say?
I said I thought she was giving it to Alan. Dickie could have some.
He got the rest of the bed.
Brett, what did you say?
Well, honey, I'm a mathematician, and I added two and two, and I quickly came up with five. And I've been to their house for dinner, and she feeds him a poison mushroom every night, seven nights a week.
He's got a powerful constitution. What'd you say?
Well, you see, one poison mushroom wouldn't kill you. It would just make you sick. So I thought that she'd give it to somebody that makes us sick. Brett.
Well, there's one.
Show and tell, Juliet.
Yeah, well, I know all the love on this panel, but I'm sure it's giving to Brett.
Well, everybody loves everybody. That's two for you, Richard.
I love Brett, although I don't think she's beautiful.
Brett. And Betty.
Well, I am appalled. On the first day of the new year,
I certainly
wouldn't do a thing like that. I would give it to Brett.
Message for you.
Hello there.
Thought I wouldn't make it. How much time?
Oh, no time.
Oh, Gene Rayburn, Match Game 74. Goodbye. You're all splendid.
Goodbye.
75. This is Johnny. Speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson, Bill Sadman production.